The farm gate price of fish products in Bataan Province drops amid the oil spill. Fishers group Pamalakaya says a kilo of the fish Sardinella abelia, local name Alubaybay, is now selling at just 50 pesos per kilogram from the previous 120 pesos. Aside from the low prices, the group also decrying the fishermen's struggle to catch fish due to the water contamination. Pamalakaya is now urging government to provide 15,000 peso monthly economic subsidy to help fishermen recover the daily losses due to the recent calamities. Meanwhile, the Interior Department is looking into allegations of oil smuggling involving the sunken tanker MKTR Terra Nova. It was carrying 1.4 million liters of industrial fuel when it capsized at the height of the typhoon-enhanced southwest monsoon last July 25. While its valves have been sealed, authorities said it may take up to 2 weeks before they could even drain the tanker.
Maraming naperwisyo sa negosyo. Marami na perwisyo sa trabaho, mga mangingisda, mga fish pond operators. So dapat may managot dito. Basta ako naniniwala lahat ng angulo, check-in.
The newly appointed acting trade chief vows to address challenges faced by micro, small, and medium enterprises in the country as she starts her work officially today. Now, before stepping up, Cristina Aldeguerre Roque served as trade undersecretary in charge of developing MSMEs. She believes she has a lot to contribute to the agency and the government given her three-decade experience.
The MSME comprises 99.5% of the businesses in the country, and 60% of the labor force is MSME. So this sector cannot be denied. An instantaneous increase in the sales or in the income of the MSME is an instantaneous increase in the economy of the country. So this is a very crucial and very important focus. I feel excited because I feel I have a lot to give to the department. I'm exposed to so many challenges, so many opportunities. I've met a lot of people who are willing to help, willing to contribute, willing to drive all of the MSME.
Roque also laying down her plans as the new leader of the trade portfolio.
The priority will be one for the international trade. We will continue to work extensively with the BOI, the PEZA, and all other agencies that will push for international investments and investors coming in the country. Because one, we need that very badly, or we need that to be able to drive the economy, and we need that also to be able to give jobs to the people. Number two, another important is the consumer protection. Why? We need to protect the consumers from the products that are being brought in and from the products that we have. Fair trade, so that it's fair for everyone. And of course, the MSMEs. Okay.
Former Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual resigned last week as he seeks to return to private sector. The seasoned banker, meanwhile, denied a particular incident triggered him to leave the Marcos cabinet. The House begins deliberations on the proposed 6.352 trillion peso 2025 national budget today. And first to face the House are four members of the President's economic team who comprise the Development Budget Coordination Committee, or DBCC. You've got Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto, NEDA Director General Arsenio Balisacan, and Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor Eli Remolona. They will brief House members on the state of the Philippine economy and the macroeconomic assumptions used in putting together the proposed 2024 spending program. House Speaker Martin Romualdez says he wants to see increased allocations for pro-poor services and programs to ensure that economic growth, which is pegged at 5.9 to 6.2% next year, will be felt by all. Now, on Tuesday, PAGCOR and PCSO, both major contributors to the National Treasury, will brief lawmakers and appropriations for their operations, while the Department of Environment and Natural Resources and the Department of Human Settlements and Urban Development will be on deck for Wednesday. Plus, on Thursday, you've got the Department of Energy, Commission on Higher Education, and Energy Regulatory Commission facing House lawmakers. The chief of the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, or PCSO, suing U.S.-based vlogger Claire Contreras, known as Maharlika. PCSO General Manager Melquiades Robles says he filed defamation per se, and false light invasion of privacy against Contreras in California following the vlogger's accusation against him for allegedly embezzling public funds, contract killing, and assisting terrorists. Robles thinks his association with the current administration may be the reason he has been the target of the attacks, as Contreras is a known critic of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. PCSO had been in the spotlight recently for the multiple winners in its digit games.